Well, good evening. I wanted to talk to you just a little bit about Gray Leaf Spot. Usually we record a YouTube video, but I decided that this time, just because of time, I wanted to get it recorded on Vimeo. And I'm going to give you just a little bit of background on Gray Leaf Spot, our primary enemy. Remember, we have lots of different enemies when it comes to foliar disease, the spectrum of diseases that we've dealt with in the past has changed. It used to be just gray leaf spot. Today we talk about northern corn leaf blight, southern rust, tar spot. But gray leaf spot, that thing that we dealt with 25 years ago, is still the dominant player. That could change in the future, but it's probably worth understanding this one just a little bit better. And that's the purpose of the slide set that we're going to go through here together today. Gray leaf spot is caused by this little pathogen. We could spell it out there, Cercospora zeaemates. But basically, it's a fungus. What I'm going to present here is a simplified life cycle. I've exaggerated the size of some of the things in this life cycle just to give you kind of a better understanding of how the pathogen works. But the whole idea here is to make this enemy unknown. We see the spots, we see the lesions, but I want you to appreciate kind of everything that leads up to that leaf blight that we call gray leaf spot. So the very first step in gray leaf spot is we have something called conidiophores that arise from these things called stromata. And if you were to look in a leaf, kind of in the cross section of a leaf, you'd see this fuzzy looking thing, this mass of fungal hair that's called a stromata. And this dense mass of fungal hair that's embedded in the residue is actually the overwintering structure, and it's pretty hardy. And the fact that it overwinters within residue kind of explains one of the things that we deal with when it comes to gray leaf spot, and that is that residue tends to increase our risk of seeing disease. Now, what eventually happens once we get into the latter spring is that those overwintering stromata shoot out these little mushroom-like things, if you want to call it that, these little fungal hairs that can produce spores, and they're called conidiophores. And this really sets the stage for spore production that eventually infects the leaf and creates all those little rectangular lesions that we worry about that can subtract yield. The step after this is called conidia release, and don't get too wound up about this, but just remember, we start out with this fuzzy thing in the leaf that overwinters. It's really hardy, allows it to survive those really harsh winter conditions. That spits out these structures that produce spores, and conidia is the technical name for the spores that are released. These are asexual spores. We could talk about what they look like there. You can read about how many sections they have and all that. But one of the important things to be aware of is that these spores are moved around by wind and rain, and that explains one of the things that also environmentally promotes gray leaf spot. That is that rain and wind splash and move this thing around. When we have a lot of splashing rain, we feel like that accelerates GLS movement, the movement, the appearance, I should say, of those lesions up into the canopy. After those conidia are released, they land on the leaf. You can see my example of that over on the left. And those conidia then germinate and they produce these structures. Again, forgive me for the technical term, but these little structures that are called apressoria. And so we'll go through that here in just a bit. So when the spore lands, if we have enough moisture, it shoots out a germ tube. Now, if it's dry, that germ tube kind of withers. That's another reason we need some moisture out there to promote gray leaf spot, because we don't want that little germ tube, or the fungus, I should say, doesn't want that little germ tube to wither. And eventually that little germ tube stretches out and it grows over those natural openings in the leaf that conduct water, that release water from the leaf. Those little holes in the leaf are called stomata. And this apressoria, this little structure, is formed over those holes in the leaf. And it's this that's going to form stuff that actually penetrates into the leaf itself. So what happens at this point is that little structure that's over the openings in the leaf produces these things that are called infection pegs. I'm not going to get into that too much, but this is kind of what precedes the growth of all this fungal hair into the leaf that eventually kills tissue and results in those rectangular lesions that you're very familiar with. So you can see here in the example on the left, we eventually have lots of fungal hairs develop. They start growing through the leaf surface. They start to consume leaf cells. They start to feed off the nutrients within those cells, and they eventually produce new stromata, like what we originally saw on the bottom right-hand side of the screen. They produce new stromata, and the cycle all starts all over again. So those fungal hairs devour the material. They eventually produce these fungal hairs that can produce spores. More spores are released, etc. Now, from the period of time that the spore lands on the leaf to new spores being produced, so that little kind of weird banana-shaped like spore lands on the leaf and it grows stuff that infects the root. From the period of time it lands on the leaf to lesions being produced that are releasing new spores, that's a period of about 2 to 3 weeks. And the spores, actually, the formation of those lesions takes maybe about 10 days from the period of time that the spore contacts to the leaf to the actual development of those odd lesions. And then, of course, the cycle just repeats itself, and that's kind of the process that we go through for gray leaf spot. What's important for you to know is those little kind of structures, the little germ things that stretch out from the spore and then grow over the surface of the leaf, part of the reason we apply fungicide is to stop that little pancake-like thing that covers the leaf and starts to grow into it. It stops the germ tube, it stops the formation of those aprosoria, and hopefully this helps you understand just a little bit better why we need moisture, why moisture plays a big role, why splashing rain plays a big role, and why residue increases our risk. So that's your exposure to this enemy. Our topic, again, was gray leaf spot, and hopefully you understand this big player in foliar disease just a little bit better. Thanks a lot for watching. We'll talk with you soon.